Okay, welcome everybody. Coffee and Art in the Morning. I'm Dee Dee, and it's Monday morning. I love Monday mornings. I don't know that everybody does, but I do. I love me some Monday mornings. So I'm going to do a little quick show and tell of what I've been working on. We are going to give away the Color My Sketchbook Bennett Klein Book 1. I printed out all the names that applied, that put a comment on my blog, minus duplicates. There's a couple of duplicates here, or comment removed, because they knew they had accidentally put a duplicate. So other than the duplicates that were removed, I went through and numbered them all, so we'll do a random.org. I guess we could go ahead and do that right off the bat, because, you know, it's the giveaway is closed. I closed it Friday night. Then I, you know, printed them all out, numbered them all, read them all, went through them all, make sure there was no duplicates. So we have 113. So if I, we'll go ahead and do that right now, because, you know, it's not going to be a challenge to do this, and in case people are wanting to know who won. So let's go over to random.org and okay, so we'll go to random.org and we're going to put in between one, let me see, I'll have to readjust the camera because it's going to flash out to one. Did I say 113? Let me make sure. To 113. So I'm going to put in 1 to 113. Whoops, not 10,013. Wait a minute. 113. Okay, so we have, there we go, you can see it. So we have the numbers between 1 and 113. So let's see who wins the Bennett Klein sketchbook. We're going to generate 13. So number 13. So let's go through here and see who has 13. 13 is Crochet Pat. Pat Crochets. So she gets the book, and I think, I'm pretty sure I have Pat's address. I don't see her here, but yeah, so congratulations, Pat Crochets. Well, can y'all see it? Let me do the focus thing for just a minute so everybody can see. Let's get everybody to see. Well, where's my card here? Where's my Sherry card? There we go. So, Pat, you are number 13. So, congratulations. Yeah. So, let me put a sticker on there. I know, right? So, that was fun. I love doing, you know, giveaways on Ustream and YouTube. And I'll, you know, try to do as many as I can. So this goes to Pat Crochets. Yeah. I know. Julie Thomas, congrats, Pat. Okay, so we got that done. Now let me go back over to my iPad. And, oh, and we will be giving away our pack today. Where's our pack? Week 6. I think it's week 6. It could be week 7. I just wrote this on thinking it was week 6. I'm pretty sure it's week 6. It doesn't really matter what week it is. I'm giving one away every Monday. So we'll see who gets that in a little bit. So, yeah. So let's go over to my pictures. Y'all have any questions, put them in caps. And if you're watching this over on YouTube, this is a recording on Ustream with a live chat, a live audience, a live, yeah, mostly alive. We're not including Jean. She may be asleep. No, she said she was getting up. okay, LBO. So, yeah. So, let me show you some of the things I'm working on. So, a while back, let me show you this one first. So, a while back, Mitch's mom, and she's already posted on Facebook, and I've reposted it. So, if y'all want to see it better, you can see it on Facebook. But she wanted me to do, because she'd already bought the picture of Mitch that I'd done on for the Gold Rush guys, and then she wanted me to do a picture of her and her husband, and they have a thing in their family where there's a certain clock that means something to them, and what they do is they always take photographs in front of the clock. Hey, Jean, they take photographs in front of the clock on the, is it the date they got engaged or the date they got married. I forget which it is. And they do it by the time on the clock. So this was she and her husband. This is the mom and her husband. So this was what I... Let's see if I can get it to... There. They're on Facebook. But anyway, so she had hired me to do them. Then when Mitch got married, the Gold Rush Mitch, she wanted me to do Mitch and his wife. So that's the one I just finished. Don't know if you're going to... And you're not seeing the colors, guys, because you know this paper is tan, right? So you're obviously not seeing the colors. I don't know if I can... Let me see if I... I don't know if auto... Let's see here. Let's see about right light. Let's see if I can do right light. There we go. All right. So there's Mitch and his new bride with the clock. It's the same clock. It's the same clock. They want it in their picture. So there's... Let me do the autofocus again. Dang. So let's see if we can get it to focus. I'm trying, guys. But anyway, so there's Mitch and his wife. And then let me go back to... this was the other one. This is the mom and dad. There's the mom and dad. Can y'all see? Yeah. Okay, so that's what I did over the weekend. That. And I have the autofocus on, so if it starts zooming, let me know and I'll turn that off. Then, Kenny hired me to do her granddaughter, which, now Kenny, it's only just in the beginning stages, so I'm just going to show you. In the beginning stages, so I'm working on her granddaughter here. And again, I just started the shading, but this is her granddaughter. There we go. It kind of clicked in a little. So that's how far I got so far. She's such a cutie. She's adorable. So I'm working on her. So that's what I've been doing there. And then what else? Oh, then I did a little bit of, let me check my list to make sure I got that done. So I know, isn't she cute? And then I got my Copic folder with all my different paper testing and all this stuff that I squeezed in a few minutes during the weekend. And I did a couple little tests with just three of the papers. I still have to do some all the cardstock. I know there's a lag, guys. Y'all are just now saying how cute she is. Yeah. I'm just seeing it. So, okay, let's go back to, hang on, where's my man? Let's get the focus. Hang on, guys, because white paper wants to flash out, so let's get the right line. Hang on, guys. I'll probably have to readjust it when we go to color, too. Because, you know, it's all flashed out now because of the white paper. So, anyway, I'm testing some little samples here, like with the Aqua Bee paper. I did, a couple things to see how much it went through. I just wrote the colors I'm using on the back to test how much it comes through the paper and all. And just a couple little tests. So I did that one. The Strathmore Bristol. I did some little flower samples. I did some with ink, some with not blending, just to see. Hang on, guys. Let me work on this lighting situation a minute. Where's my card? Where's my Sherry card? Where's my Sherry card? Hang on. All right. Wants to focus. Hang on, guys, because I have white. Hang on. I gotta go back to this to get to get it back. I have to do this. All right. Okay. Now it's probably gonna be really flashed out. Yeah. Sorry, guys. I every time you put something white in front of the camera, it messes it up. So I gotta continuously adjust the lighting. Okay, we'll leave this right here. Okay, so then with the Strathmore, the Strathmore Bristol, I did. Oh my gosh, it flashed out again. Oh, sorry, guys. Anyway, it's just a couple little samples. Here's where I blended the markers. Sorry. great. The flash out. The flash out. Oh my gosh. Okay, so here I did some blending, and here I just did some sketching to test out the different, hey, Pat, did you see that you won? Pat, you won the Bennett Klein book from the YouTube comments. Yeah. So, yeah. So, oh my gosh. Oh, save me from the white light. So here you can see where I blended some, and then I blended here. This is with just Copics. Just remember, guys, I'm new at this, right? I'm starting to grow like Jean. I'm in good company, Janet. So this is, I'm just starting to learn how to blend them. And then this one is where I did sketching, like sketch, not blending, just using them like to sketch with, without blending. So there's those samples, and that's what the again, see, I wanted to test how much it came through. So there's that little test, and this is only 3 papers. That's all I had time for. Yeah, it's the first time you won anything? Oh, good, Pat. Well, I'm glad you won then. Don't go into the line. And then the render paper, which, you know, you saw that I did the test. I got this render paper at Blick that Saturday on my birthday. And the render paper does not go through. Did I do more than one? Here. So here I just did a couple little clouds with 2 shades of blue. Just to practice, you know, guys, I'm new at this. And it does, I was going to say it doesn't go through. That doesn't go through. That's just my test numbers. But here's where the clouds are. See where the clouds are? It does not go through. Well, you can see on this side. That didn't go through to this side, and that didn't go through to that side. So, yeah, like that render paper. So those are my little samples. And sorry guys, let me take a sip of coffee. And my other test papers here, and then some of my skin tone list and color combinations. Oh, so here's the other paper. You know, we did do a test of the Staples cardstock, and then I got the Georgia Pacific cardstock. They're both 110 weight, and look at the difference. See how much vibrant that this one is? And that's the one from Walmart. And, so we'll talk more about the papers and what we can do with them and all that later. Because, you know, I don't want to spend too much time on that because we got a color today. All right, so let's put that aside. And this aside. And, okay, so now we got to brighten everything back up again. Well, let's see what we're going to do in the dragon book, because that'll probably flash it out again. Oh, my gosh. So, I already did a little bit. Let's do the right light again. I already did the, started some backgrounds in here. If you have any questions, put them in caps so I know you're talking to me. Okay. And I'll adjust the light when we actually go to color. So we'll see what happens when we do a flip. So there's other people I've already done the flip of the dragon book, but I've already started doing some things in it. Let me take my black paper out. So you can see, like here I did Copics, and it does go through. It goes through. That's why you got to put a paper behind it, right? So, Hey, Samurai, anybody else popping in? Yep, if I don't see you, welcome. So I'm going to just kind of do a quick flip through here. Let's see what the light does. So you can see what's in the book. And so some of them, like, if it goes through here, then you can see where I've colored it. Some already have black in the background for you already. So obviously I didn't go over that. But like here, I just used a Sharpie marker, a black Sharpie to do the background. And it goes through, but again, I don't care. It's one side of paper. These are going to get torn out as I go, and put in my binder anyway. So, yeah. So I'm just going to kind of do a quick little flip for you. And I have not decided which one I'm going to do today. See, like this one. This was already a black background. So, you see, because it didn't go through. So I'm just going to flip. I don't know which one I want to do yet, but I know I want to do one today. And what we're going to do, I think, is we're going to do some watercolor. Here's where I did a Copic purple. No shading or anything. That's just the background. See how it goes through? Okay. If y'all have any questions, just put them in caps. So you can see how much, not a lot done yet, but that one's kind of cool. I like him. He's kind of a big, cool face. A lot of background, a lot of tiny detail. That may take a while. Well, that doesn't, right? So there's some more purple background. That I think this would be really cool as a green dragon with the purple in the background and some kind. This is, I think it's kind of supposed to be a type of pine cone or something that he's sitting on, or some kind of flower. But I think that would be cool with a yellow ochre, a green, like an olive green leaf maybe, or maybe an orange, maybe a yellow flowery pineapple pine cone thing. I think it's probably a pineapple. And then have the dragon in greens, a purple background, and then maybe a combination of all the colors in the background. I don't want to get my copy of Dragons. I've seen just beautiful work from this book already. Well, you see, that's the wrong thing to think of that way, Mel. Yeah. I do, too. I like the purple background. That's just a flat Copic. You know, to make it no lines. Like if you use a regular marker, you'd probably have lines. But you could do it with watercolor, too. Now, granted, this paper is thin. So when I use watercolor, I'm going to have to be judiciously careful with the amount of water and dry between layers. Because it will wrinkle. It will wrinkle. Don't email me. But I do like that one. I might do that one because I can just see a lot of, we can do a lot of shading on those, what are those called? Not planks. I want to call them planks. you know, those circle things. and again, I'll go ahead, like, maybe I'll color this one with the Copic just so you can see. Where's my, but I don't forget to do this. Don't forget to put something behind it because it will go through. So we'll color the background of this one, but I think I'll go back and do the purple. There's this one. And I'm just doing a quick flip. You can see them all online. You know, scales. Yeah, scales. I kept saying, I'm thinking planks. Scales. Yeah. Thanks, girls. Scales, yes. And this one I think is going to be fun because it's like a, crystal ball. That'll be cool. That'll be cool to stickles, to either stickles or, you know, some kind of twinkling H2Os or something. This is the one you do, Dee. I love the purple background. That's the one to do. Yeah, I like the purple too. You guys. And here's another one with no background yet. This one has a pattern in it, you know, which the grayscales, you just color it one color and you got, you know, you got the pattern showing through. And then this one, yeah. So, yeah, so those are all the ones. So let me go ahead and go back to this one, and I don't want to do another purple. I've already done two with a purple background. So we'll do this one with a different color background. And I know it's kind of, you know, the light's weird, guys, but when I'll zoom in to when we start actually coloring. But in the meantime, what colors should we do? I'm thinking, because I already done, you know, the black and the purple. This is going to have like a, this would be cool. It's a phoenix bird. And like if we did like a green dragon and a red phoenix, so I don't know, maybe like a rich brown might be good. What do y'all think? Let's see. One of these colors. Let me do a test. I'm liking this brown, so we're going to go with this. Okay, so I'll zoom in one, but I'm not really going to adjust all the lighting and stuff until we go to do, because we're going to do the watercolor and all that, you know. Let me focus, though, on the next page. So we'll just do a little here. There we go. Yeah, well, I'm going to do a red brown. It's like a sienna. Okay, it's going to be a sienna because I think that'll be pretty if we did a red and an orange phoenix and maybe a green and a blue dragon. Oh, yes, baby. That would be awesome. So I'm just going to kind of color in. Again, let's make sure that I have this right behind because it goes right through. Goes right through. This doesn't really take long. And you just, you know, got to be careful not to oversaturate right next to the line. Because if you get it right up next to the line and get it real wet, it's going to bleed into the other. But as long as you don't, you know, get it too oversaturated, I found while doing the purple one. That it didn't, like, cross over the line. As long as I didn't get it too wet right next to the lines. That makes sense. And again, guys, I'm not used to using Copic, so bear with me as we learn together. If y'all have any questions, put them in caps. So when I do a flat background like this, I do like to have the background done if I know for a fact what color I want to do, whether it's black or, you know, whatever color. I like to do the background because it kind of gets it situated how you want to go from there. Just watch and see if I've got any questions or anything. Green dragons are happy. We prove that in the university. Okay, Anita. I'm sure there's a story behind that. Green dragons being happy. Yeah. I mean, you know, you can color any color them pink, purple, blue, yellow, any color you want, right? So I'm just going to do this background here, and then we'll go and do the watercolor on the other one. So I want to use all different mediums. I want us to do all kinds of different things. I do have some plans to do my own watercoloring with, you know, some line art and stuff, but that'll just be as I have time, guys, because, you know, it's always about the time, isn't it? So many projects, so little time. And my commissions, you know, I do the those go in between my stream days, so it's not like when I'm not here I'm not doing anything. you're making me want to get your Spectrum Noir markers out. They're getting dusty. Break those babies out. Oh my gosh, Angie, for sure. Your stone angel would never end up looking. Oh, but Jean, and bless her heart. Now I'm going to talk about Jean. Now she's here, so it's not behind her back. Jean did a stone angel. She was trying to, who was it? Frugal Crafter? That I didn't see that her project, so I'm thinking it, you said that Jean was trying to do a project based off of Frugal Crafter's Stone Angel. Am I right, Jean? And it didn't turn out. I'll just say it that way. Jean, it didn't turn out how Jean imagined. However, that being said, Jean got to show people, like, as she was doing the project and it wasn't doing what she wanted it to, she was able to say, oh, I wanted this to happen and it didn't. This happened. And she was talking the process out. I love, like, that's one of the things I love about long videos or non-speeded up videos, especially if you're doing something like a demo. Jean and I don't call ourselves tutorialists or teachers. But if you're doing a demo and you're talking it out and it doesn't work, everybody can see why. They can see why it didn't work. You know, if you're doing it and you're not embarrassed or afraid that something's not going to turn out, trust me, Jean and I don't get embarrassed easy. Dilly sassy. And so we just carry on. If it doesn't turn out, then, you know, you see what not to do. So Jean, she was a real trooper. She just kept on going and said, this ain't working, this ain't working. But she kept on. and it didn't work like she wanted it to, for sure. But, you know, you got to see what didn't work and why it didn't work. Because Jean let you see every step. Which I thought was quite brave of her. But that's our sassy pants. Okay, so let's see. All right, here's some more little bits right here behind the little phoenix. So I'm just getting in there. And I'm not doing any blending at this point, guys, with the Copics. I mean, I've done a little practice with blending, but, you know, it is a skill. It is a skill. And with any skill comes practice. And practice takes time. I love hearing the thought process. That's why I'm here. Oh, good, Miss Romantica. It's aroma. It's aroma. It's not romantic. It's aroma. Aromatica. Aromatica. I'm going to have to say it like that. Yeah, Jean says, it's true. I couldn't teach middle school if I got embarrassed easy. So true. Yeah, and Jean is not afraid. Trust me, Scooby. If you've been around Jean the last, you know, years, she at one point could not, it would freak her out to let paint touch her hands. I'm not joking. Jean has come a long, long way. And so, but yeah. It's fun to watch her experiment with new things. I really found, and you know, even though her stone angel, which to me, that's a tricky one right there. I haven't seen Frugal Crafter's video, so I don't know what it was supposed to look like, Jean. But Jean really is doing some awesome watercolor landscapes. Even though her stone angel didn't turn out, her landscapes are really good. So, yeah, she did some acrylic paintings for Christmas gifts on canvas or canvas board, Jean. I don't remember. I think they're on canvas, and she did some triptychs or, anyway, she did a lot of painting for Christmas gifts. Hey, Paula, good to see you. You're going to have to talk to work. They're cutting into your stream time big time. Big time cutting into your streams, Paula. You like this background? Yeah, I like this color. It's a sienna. Well, the number is, I guess I could be telling y'all numbers, right? E08, and it's just called brown, but it's really like a sienna color. It's like a red brown, right? But it's called brown, so we're just going to color the whole background. It's pretty quick when you just do like this. You know, I could do a paintbrush and acrylic paint, too, which y'all see me do that. So, you know, just whatever. It's all good. And while the marker is wet, it'll keep blending edges. So you won't have marker lines. As long as you keep the wet edge, you know, you have to keep that wet edge going. Not as much as you do on a lot of markers. But, because Copics are made for blending. But it is best, I found, just even in my little paper tests, to keep the edge wet. See how I got a little bit, so I'm going to kind of go over that like that and kind of try to blend it out a little. A couple were on... Wait, let me see. I missed something Jean said. A couple were on... 16-inch canvas, and the other were 8x10 wood canvas. Okay. I couldn't remember, Jean, but you did some good paintings, especially if you think how far Jean has come. Seriously. And she only has 10% vision. And we don't talk about that all the time, but, you know, our Jean does amazing for what she does. I mean, she's a music teacher. Well, she's retired now, but a music teacher all her life or all her adult life, you know, with 10% vision. So you got to admire her. Trust me, after 2 eye surgeries, I admire Miss Jean. you finally got in, Dot. You've been trying for a half hour. Welcome, Miss Dot. All right, so we're almost done. See, this goes pretty quick. Oh, I got a little over the line, but we're going to color over it anyway, so it's not going to matter. I don't really worry too much about, you know, if you go a little bit out of line or something, you know, I know we're trying to be very detailed and do it as nice as we can, for sure, especially our Bennett Klein. Right, Laura? Okay, so there we go. See, that went pretty fast. Let me make sure there's no little holes anywhere that I might have missed. Okay. So again, do not forget to put your paper behind it, because look, people, it goes right through. Now, I could have printed this out. I could have printed it out on cardstock and done it, you know, that away. But I'm just going to be honest with you guys. Once I color a page, unless I'm doing something special for somebody, you know, like I sent a couple out, you know, doing samples and stuff, I'm not going to probably color another page twice. So, you know, I'm just doing it on the paper that came in the book, mostly for you guys to see what happens when you just do it in the book, okay? But there's nothing wrong. Just print it out on cardstock if you want to keep a nice, nicer, you know, paper. I am going to also print, I am, for an example, so you can see, I want to print one out on craft color paper, and I'd like to do the whole thing in black and white. So I might do that next. Not today. But a craft, let's just call it a craft dragon. with black and white. So I would like to post that on Bennett Klein's page. So I might do that the next time we do a dragon. Okay. If y'all have any questions, put them in caps. Okay, so now let's go ahead, and this is, feel it, it's cold. If it's cold, it's still damp. So I'm going to go ahead and hit it with the heat gun. Do you tear out the page of the color to make a copy? I tear it out to make a copy. Because Charlie Girl, they go, all these, the single-sided pages like this that don't have a story to them, like Mouse Guard, I'm not going to tear those pages out. It's like a full-on storyline thing, you know. But like these dragons are like individual stories and they're one-sided. So I'm going to cut them out and put them in my binder, my three-ring binder in page protectors. So, yeah, I'll tear it out to make a copy. And, yeah. Phoebe, it's been a while. I saw Paula mention Phoebe. I didn't see Phoebe come in, but hi, Phoebe. Yee says I couldn't. Yeah, links are open, guys, if y'all want to post your products and supplies and enable. Okay, so now that one's good. So I'm going to take this out here, and let's go back to the purple one. All right, so now we're going to do, and you could do this with Neo colors or whatever, but I want to, because I have plans with Copics and I'm just going to bend the spine as much as I can. I could just tear it out because I'm going to tear it out anyway, but I'll work in the book for a while. And watercolor. So we'll consider this like a practice page, right? All right, so that looks pretty good, guys, right there. Let me see if I can lock the light in right there until we start color and shading with pencil. We start shading, I'll zoom in so you can see that. But right now we're going to be working in watercolor over the kind of the whole page. So I'll keep it kind of zoomed out for a minute. So I'm going to use these, I'm not sure how you pronounce it, Bianyo, it's B-I-A-N-Y-O. And so we're going to work with these. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take my water and I'm going to move away here and I'm going to spritz the whole thing so they're all wet, okay? So they're all wet and get juicy and ready to use. So if y'all have any questions, just ask. Okay, so now I get my water brush. Let's make sure that, yep, there's water in it. And I'm going to do a wash. So like I said earlier, I think I want him green, the pineapple, fronds, if you would. I think I'm going to do that in kind of an ochre color. I'm going to do these leaves in a different, maybe a sienna, and we'll see. That's kind of what I have in mind. And the background, I might wait on doing that because I'm not sure yet until we get the base done. Okay, so let me get a test paper here. Here's a test paper. Cam and I were FaceTiming while I was working on my portraits, and he was doing... Oh, that was the other thing I was going to show you. I forgot. when I was showing you what I did this weekend, let me show you what Cam's working on. He's working on a couple projects. But the one that we showed the portrait last week where he started it for the fifth grade class. Remember, his art club, each one is assigned a fifth grader to do a portrait. Oh, you have these coming tomorrow, Kimberly? Oh, for Valentine's Day. Awesome. So anyway, Cam was assigned this particular fifth grader, which I showed you before, but he's carried it further now. So let me show you how far he's got on this. He's got a little flower headband because there's going to be butterflies floating around it. This is just a close-up of the portrait. So this is how far he's got so far. And there's leaves and butterflies all around her. So he decided, and again, the flowers are not done, but he's making her a headband with the flowers. So this is how far he's got so far. It's a little flashed out, but it's pretty good. So yeah, so that's what he's working on for the fifth. That's a fifth grader. So isn't it awesome, guys? Hope the colors are kind of coming through. So yeah. All right, so anyway, I said that to say this is paper right here is, okay, now we have pink. Now we have pink. Do we have pink? Well, we'll see. Yeah, it's a little pink, but I know, isn't it good? I know. So I'm going to test. I have a piece of cardstock here to test my colors is what I'm saying. Let me do it on this side. Let's see, because I want kind of an olivey green. Yeah, and this is a dark olive. That one's too green, and that one's darker still. So I think I'll go with this one. All right, so I'm going to go with this dark, kind of dark olive. And I'm just going to, not going to zoom in yet because I'm just going to, I know, isn't he doing awesome? And he told me his art teacher has watched my show. So hello, Cam, art teacher, if you're watching. That's awesome. All right, so again, I'm not, don't squeeze out any excess water, especially on thin paper. I'm just touching the green and putting it on. I'm not squeezing out any excess water at all. And I'm not going over and over the same spot because, again, that will peel your paper. And make it, it's not the paint that ever goes through, it's the water. I say that every show, but I don't want anybody to email me. Okay, so I think I'm going to go with the one shade darker green. It's probably not going to show up very much on here, but I'm going to go, if you want more water, squeeze your brush while it's here. Like squeeze out more water if you need to on the paint itself. Don't squeeze out any water here. Oh, that way too much there. And so it's thin enough, well, of course, watercolor is, but it's thin enough for you to see the color book pages still under it. I'm thinking maybe I want his horned area, some of these things, a different color. I'm not going to color those horns yet. And of course, I'm going to shade with pencil. Let me get a Kleenex. I clean my water brush off with the Kleenex as you go. I know. Cam is 17. Is that what you're asking? Yeah, he's 17. He just turned 17. He's a junior. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so let's keep going here. He's been on the show. He's been on the show. All right, so again, I'm going to go down here and get this background. Some of this lighter area here along his, you know, like the edge scales. I'm not sure what that's called on a dragon, but the scales that are on the edge and the little horn areas, I think I might do them another color. Don't know. I'm going to get, you know, I want to just kind of get what I know colors I want done. He probably was a fifth grader back when I first started streaming. I've been streaming for 6 years. So, yeah. A lot of girls here remember Cam when he was younger. And he'd be on the show and be in the studio. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know, right? Let me show. Let's see. Do I have a picture? Let me see. Hang on, guys. Let me look here. Do I have it on my iPad? Because I don't want to show it on my phone because it flashes out the camera. So, do I have it here? Let's see. Let me check. Yeah, here we go. So here's this is me and Cam at Thanksgiving. Let me save that. I know he's not my little fifth grader anymore, for sure. Not my little fifth grader. All right, so here he is. That's us at Thanksgiving. When we, well, it was before Thanksgiving's when, well, no, it was right after Thanksgiving's when we went to get the Christmas tree. So look how tall he is. I mean, I'm 5'5" and a half. He's probably 5'8" maybe, close to 5'8". So yeah, so that's my Cambo right there. Yeah. So, okay, back to work. He was a youngin', and Boo, she will be in high school next year. She's in eighth grade. She'll be in high school next year. Let me see if I have a picture of her to show you. We might as well, right? You know, because it's my show, and if I want to show my grandchildren, I can, right? let's see. Bum. It's taking a second to download. Come on. Come on. All right, why is it taking a minute? I'm trying to make it do too many things at once. That one doesn't want to download for some reason. That one's fine. One moment. All right, let's try and find a different one. Here she is. There's Boo. Yeah. Aw, thanks, Jessica. All right, back to what we are here for. Thanks, guys. They're sweet. All right, so this tail kind of curls. Again, I'm just putting a wash on here. It's really, you know, nothing to see in, as far as detail goes. So I'm just going to keep. I'm not oversaturating the paper. All right, now let's see. I think I'll do that one shade lighter green. Let's see. For this leg here. And I think I'll do his claws even a separate color. And there's a few little variation shades of green that I'm doing here that may be kind of hard to see. But I think I want that area of his leg, his claws. And these like back scales to be a different color. I know. Thanks, guys. All right, let's see. All right, let's go ahead and do his wings. Again, there's some back claw bits there that I'm not going to do green because I think I might want to do them. Maybe a dark purple. Dark purple with the purple background would probably look good. So, gotta concentrate a little on what areas I'm coloring so that I can do those two colors. Do the scales. Oh, there's a area purple that I forgot to Copic. Have to get that out. That background. So tell me again. I like to hear what everybody's coloring. I think Laura's coloring in the Dragon book. At least she has one going, I think. Anybody else coloring in the Dragon book? The Bennett Klein Dragon book? If not, just tell me what you are coloring in, if you are coloring. This is just a base wash, just to get rid of the white of the paper. I'll kind of watch chat for a second so I can see what y'all are coloring. This will be darker back here. Another piece of a wing back here. The Harry Potter Dragon book, Bunny. Oh, okay. Yeah, you got all, didn't you get all the Harry Potter books at one point? I thought you were talking about it. Coloring Mom is Angie. Kangaroo Bay is coloring Enchanted Forest. Jessica J. Love is in Daydreams. Yeah, I saw that on Carol Renee's in Imagimorphia and Colin Thompson's book. A little dark right there. Anita's in Harry Potter. Karen K is in black background in. Oh wait, yes, I'm coloring black back. Oh, black backgrounds that aren't black yet. Okay. Miss Aroma is getting the new Bennett Klein, and because she hasn't made any previous headway on the other four. Terry Trouble is virtually coloring Imagimorphia. Oh my gosh, Terry. That's hilarious. Fran is in going to do planning a zine. Kim is in Exotic Animals by Marty Wood. Jean is in I Don't Color Much. But you did do the fashion one. Barb W is in Cotton Peter Cottontail. That's going by pretty fast, guys, if I miss it. Ranja is totally hooked on mixed media collage. Yeah, we'll do another mixed media maybe Wednesday. I'm trying to do maybe coloring on Monday, collage or mixed media projects on Wednesday. That's kind of like how I'm kind of doing it, you know, and Copics in between, like little as I'm learning things with Copics, we're doing that kind of in between when we have you know, in between projects. Country Scenes by Michelle Lee. Or Michelle Lee's coloring country scenes. Phoebe's not coloring. Scooby is in Summer Nights. The lookbook. Yeah, that's what it is, Jean. The lookbook. Janet is painting her nails. I did mine too, Janet. Got the this is Sinful Shine, and it's Rendezvous. Rendezvous. Kind of a turquoisey color. Doodlers Anonymous for Vicky S. Imagimorphia and Colin Thomas with Whippy. Yeah. I'll try to see if I see it, I'll keep looking. Keep reading. All right, let's keep going over here. I'm gonna spray my watercolors again to keep them wet. Yeah, Jean, I mean, even though her angel, her stone angel didn't turn out like she wanted, I thought it was great that she gave it the old college try. Like live, you know. That was really awesome, Jean. Okay, again, I can see where the paper starts to break down in some of these bigger areas. I got to be careful not to go through. Not that it matters 'cause, you know, it's one-sided, but yeah. I don't want this to be like one big wrinkled blob either, you know. Fancy Lime is coloring in Dreamscapes. But it will, I don't say wrinkle, it'll buckle some. Because this is just like copy paper, guys. If you don't want it to buckle at all, then you need to print it out on other some cardstock, watercolor paper, something else, okay? And you can also buy Bennett Klein's books digitally. So you can buy them digitally and print out, you know, whatever you want too, if that's easier for you. If you know you're not going to want to color in a thin paper book, then get his digital copy and print it out whatever paper you want, right? Okay, let's keep moving. Let's go over here, right on the edge. But I am trying to show as many techniques as we can with color books, especially, you know, if it doesn't take us too long. I mean, sometimes we just want to get really involved and do tiny details, like we did the Oh Dear. I think it took us 10 parts to do that one. Now, these are not chalky. I mean, I'm not saying that they're... No, I don't know. I don't know. Let's put it this way. They're not as chalky as, say, the sets, like the kids' sets, Paula. But I'm sure they're not near as good as, like, you know, these aren't Daniel Smith or something either, right? But I'm going to color over it. So even if it does have a little bit of chalky feel to it, I mean, when I say chalky feel, I mean it's not going to rub off like a chalk would. But it gives it tooth, which, because I'm going to color pencil over it, so that's even might even be a little bit of a benefit if you have the chalky watercolors. It is. Yeah, you got that instant gratification when you get the digi copies, right? All right. So, but yeah, they're not as chalky as like a kid's set, Paula. But I've done some with the kid sets too, so that are chalky. But if you're penciling over it. All right, I'm looking at it because I see the little, see a little spot right here I missed on his tail. I don't want to get in too big a hurry. You know what I mean? Burn. Eileen has a question. Are Lumi's wax or both? It says different things on, I know. I don't know, Eileen. It says different things on different ones. Some say wax, some says oil, and some says both. I don't know. And you know what? I really don't care. I don't care what they're made of. Because it doesn't matter what I'm using them. You know what I mean? It doesn't really matter to me at all. You know, as long as they work together, they work, you know, they blend. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. If it's important to you to know, I mean, not you, Eileen, but if it's important for anybody to know what the Lumis or Polys or Holbys or any of them are made out of, then, you know, do your own research, guys, because I don't know. All right, let me see. I got to find that purple. Which purple was I using for that? It was this one. Let me test. Yeah, because I have a little spot here I missed. This purple, in case y'all want to know, is VO2. Violet O4. Violet O4. And I just missed a spot right there when I was coloring the background. Because, you know, sometimes it's hard to see. Oh, is that? Yeah, here's a couple more little spots I missed. Okay, did I get them all? Nope. Here's one more, I think. That could be one, or it could be the background, or it could be one of the little fronds. But I'm going with it being the background. Yeah. Yeah, exactly, Laura. Yeah. But yeah, I know you're right, though, Eileen. People do ask. Eileen did bring it up because people do ask, but... Yeah, I don't know. I gave up trying to figure it out because there's so many opinions. I think I've had 10 different people tell me 10 different things. So, yeah. Okay, so, all right, let's see. So now I just got the base. See, it's just kind of a wash on the dragon. Now I want to do the pineapple or whatever it is. And, you know, I've had a couple people when I did the mouse guard say, oh, that was a stained glass window. It was this. It was that. And it's, okay, you know, hey, it can be whatever you want it to be. Right? It can be what. You're the boss of your color book. It can be whatever you want. Okay, I'm going to spray that down a little bit and get that ochre. See, I'm working right here. This ochre color. For the whatever that is, whether it's a I think it's a pineapple. That's what I'm going with. But I'm not, again, I'm not trying to color it like a pineapple, realistic pineapple color. All right, let's see what's that's the leaf right there. What I'm going by is what colors go well together. I'm doing by the color combination rather than is that the real color of a pineapple or is that the real color of a dragon or anything else? It's like that's a color that the combination of the colors I'm using all go together, and that's why I picked those colors. Thanks, guys. This is quick right here. You know, it's just a quick wash. It's all the detail that we add with the pencils that makes it more time consuming. Let's see. You know what? I'm not sure. Well, that could be a leaf, or it could just be another one of the big fronds. Let's see. Oh, I want to do that. Is that part of it? Yeah, that's part of it right there. That's part of it. That's part of it. And that's part of it. I need to go get me some hot coffee. My throat's starting to dry out because my coffee's cold. All right, so these two leaves and maybe just a little bit of that stem, I think I'm going to go with the sienna color. And then I'm going to do those odd bits on the dragon, the extra, you know, like back scales and stuff. I'm going to do that a dark purple. Lumis, let's see. Ye said the Lumis, I got to tilt my screen a little, I got a glare. Are expensive because they're light fast. Ye. Yeah, ye. But as far as what they're made of, you know, I don't know. I guess it just doesn't like stress me out. Okay. So we'll go with that. That's part of the dress. Okay, so now let me see about a darker purple. Let me see how this that's gonna be. I gotta spray him down a little bit again. I think this dark purple might be cool for the scales. Okay. Got a little too much water. Let me soak some of that up. Okay, guys, I gotta go run get some coffee. You know, talking for a couple hours. All right, I'll be right back, guys. One moment, please. Oh, that's better. Much better. Okay. Alrighty. Let's see. That goes out to Pat. Let's put that in the outgoing mail. And we got to, I don't want to forget at the end of to the show to do the pack, the week 6-pack giveaway. Let me make sure I leave it set now so I can see it. Okay. Now. All right, let me go ahead. I'm going to do his toenails. May not be dark enough, or maybe I just got too much water on there because I want it real dark as I can get it. There we go. If you all have any questions, put them in caps. And then I can shade even darker in certain areas. But I just kind of wanted the purple kind of in here. And it probably doesn't look too... Whoop, I picked up blue accidentally. Don't want the blue. Want the purple. There we go. Got that a little wet. Gotta watch that water. Because it will go through. It will go through. So yeah, if I'm missing, hi to you. Thanks for being here. I'll zoom in when we start doing pencil shading. I'm going to try to put some of the watercolor over some of the Copic just to see what happens too, because we are testing the Copics any chance we get to see what it'll do. Right. And that will be darker when I do with pencil right there, but I don't want to get it too dark so that you can't see the color, the line art underneath. Does anyone know how those watercolor compared to Koi? I have this set. Where is it? I have these. This set. I don't use watercolor enough. The true test is when you do an actual painting. Like, ask Jean when she tried to do, you know, that's when your true test is. I've not tried to do anything but color books with this, so I can't really compare it to, say, the Koi set, because I'm not really trying to blend and you know, other more technical, more detailed aspects of watercolor. I'm just doing a wash, you know. So it's not really, it wouldn't be fair for me to say this one's better than another. Although the Kois are probably, I don't know, they're probably maybe more pigmented, maybe. But I have no watercolors that are very expensive, guys. I mean, I think these were 30, and that's because it came with paper and a water brush. I think this one here is somewhere around 30, and I've had it for probably 20 years, so I don't even know, you know, how much, you know, really. But, yeah. Hey, North. Okay, so yeah, I can't really say from a professional standpoint how these compare, because I didn't buy them for that. You know, I just bought them to, you know, do some, testing and some ideas, some playing. You know, maybe do a couple fairies and some mermaids and combine them with Copics and different things. Now, if I got really, like, into doing those combination of supplies, then I might want to be more concerned about which brand and which one's better and all that. I mean, don't get me wrong, guys. All your questions are good. And I know they're not all directed at me. Some of y'all are just talking amongst yourself about the different things. So, yeah, this is not, you know, I tell y'all I'm not a teacher, and I'm definitely not a product reviewer. I mean, I can demo products, but, you know, as far as comparing one to the other, all I can do is like a pencil chart or something like that. But trust me, guys, if y'all want to know the properties and stuff, there's going to be a video or a site with all that information far better than I could tell you. Know what I mean, Vern? Dee, can you comment on the difference in the two color books? Which two color books, Twinkle? I mean, oh, Terry. Sorry, I thought it was Twinkle Toes. Which two? There's a glare on my screen, guys, from the window. Let me tilt that a little more. Which two color books, Terry? Terry said to compare between the two. I'm not sure what two she means. I probably missed it, Miss Terry. Missed what two color books y'all are talking about. Oh yeah, trust me, there's videos on everything on YouTube. Yeah, if you want to find out something, there's a video on it. Ask my granddaughter. She's a YouTube aficionado. She can tell you where to find every fashion, makeup, dance, cheer. She can probably tell you where to find everything on YouTube. If she wants to make something, she looks it up and does it. That's just the way she rolls. Oh, no. Compare the two watercolor brands in a book. Oh, you want me to compare the two? Well, again, I can show you, like, you know, do a little swatch. But mixing them and all that, probably we could do that another time. Because I want to finish this. So, yeah. But that would be a good thing to do, Miss Terry. Okay, let's see. Did I get all the dragon parts done? Looking. And some of this, like the edges where I've done green, and there's like on the scales, I might put a little purple shade. I might throw a little purple shade in there because you can color over, you know, you can color over. All right, so let's see. I'm liking that. Now I got to think about, I don't want the dark purple around the border. I mean, I could have it in some of the flowers, but I don't want it bordered in purple because then you're not going to be able to really tell where the dragon is. I don't want it in green. I think I'll go ahead and do the main border in the ochre. So I'm just going to quickly go along here, guys. And I know I'm not zoomed in enough to really see any detail, but there's really not a lot of detail to see at this point until we start coloring with pencil. So, and I don't want to squeeze out any water on this because these are thin lines here. It amazes the 93-year-old sister can instantly give her answers with a few. Yes, I know, right? Google is your friend. All right, let's just keep going here. And that little border, it's like a double, you know, it's like a frame border, so it's like a double border. It's funny, this is kind of so, you know, I just think back to all the clip art days when I look at stuff like this, like these borders, you know, these borders like this, because I would look up all kinds of cool borders to do when I did calligraphy and I wanted illuminated lettering and illuminated borders. Oh my gosh, there's thousands of choices to get ideas from. Okay, let's see that. Yeah, that does come around that way too. Okay, right along the bottom here. Bye, Fancy. Thanks for stopping in. Appreciate everybody that comes in, hangs out. But we all like to hang out, so. Okay. It's probably kind of light to see this, but it's just like a color, my color direction. And also, guys, if you don't know some color combinations to choose, and you want something different, not necessarily just your standard green dragon or whatever, go to design-seeds.com for all kinds, and you can even sign up and get an email or two. I think it's two emails a day for color combinations. I think they combine six. Remember our little notebook we did a few years ago, two, three years ago, the little notebook, and showed you how to use those design seed combinations in some art and ideas. Because you know we're all about the ideas. Yeah, those little notebooks. I don't think those are on YouTube, though. Those are pre-YouTube, because I've only been uploading for 2 years to YouTube. All right, I'm going to turn this kind of upside down or sideways to get to the edge here because I want to draw a straight line. Can't do it at that other angle. So Boo's got a major cheer competition next weekend. I was hoping to get up and see him this coming weekend, but it's the competition's a couple hours away, so probably won't go to that one, but still haven't seen them for my birthday. We're going to meet this weekend, but we didn't. And also send the color combinations out on Twitter every day. Yeah, I think I stopped following them on Twitter. I don't know why. I think I follow them on Instagram now. And I get that, you know, I have their emails and you can just go to their site and get tons, right? All right. Oh, wait. I got a finished one here. I mean, you don't have to subscribe to, you know, follow them on email to get, just to go to the site and get color combinations. All right. I think I'm also going to do the little flower centers. And then I might do some of the flowers themselves with the Copic purple. So I'll do those center flowers. And, oh, there's a couple little other that look like might be the same thing as the little flower centers there. So I'm going to do those. Well, we got that color that right there. Do I get them all? Yeah, because these ones are covered up. What the thing? Dee, my granddaughter's team got a bid for the Florida. Oh, good. I know. That's a tough one to get a bid. Especially a full paid bid. Boo has had that happen once. They've had bids where they've gone to the Florida competition. What's it in Florida? At Disney, the center. What's a staple? No, not the Staples. What is that? Pat, I forget. Anyway, down in Florida, Disneyland, Disney. Yeah. Disney World. Anyway, they've got bids to go, but they've had to pay. One year they didn't have to pay. You got to be really good not to have to pay. Right, Pat? Pat knows. All right, let me get my VO4 back out and do this. Let me do the small edge. I'm going to do the little centers here. See, I didn't do these before because I wasn't sure what I want to space the colors out, right? Again, I got a paper behind because look, it goes right through. Congratulations. Yeah, I'm not sure what the name of this one in Georgia is that's coming up next weekend, Pat. I could ask Denise and she could tell me immediately, but you know, which one, what the name of this coming up one is. It's a big one though. The one on it's a Saturday and a Sunday next weekend. It's a big one. I know. They get so excited. Don't make me pull out a video. I'll pull out a video in a heartbeat, Pat, and show Boo competing. Bye, other Terry. And hey, Pam, if I miss saying hi to you. I'm just looking who's coming in and out. So I'm looking, trying to see if there's anything else that I want. Oh, there's just a little bit of that left there. Anything else I want? Because I think I'm going to have these little, those will be little leaves back there. And it may even go back into around those leaves being that ochre color. So yeah, so the paper is a little buckly, but I also found that, because doing so many washes in Imagimorphia, I found that when you put the pencil over it, it starts flattening out, you know. But it doesn't bother me. At the end of the day, I'm going to tear this out and put it in a page protector. So you just got to kind of be aware of the different papers. This is a thin one. Now what I wanted to do, I wanted to test my purple and shadow over the top of Copics. I just want to see what's going to happen. Okay, it's kind of laying on there. Now this paper's so thin and absorbent, so it does kind of go right in, shade it, but I'm not sure if it was on cardstock if it would do the same. Does that make sense? And I could just do this with a Copic too, another darker Copic, but I just wanted to see what would happen if I put some of the dark. And I don't want to get that too dark in there because then it'll be the same as the horns there. So, because I'm going to shade with pencil too. I just want to see what would happen. So, it does lay on top. But again, I'm wetting that paper. I got to be careful. It's going to start peeling and tearing. Can you show a piece of Bennett Klein's grayscale on a page of his dark book? I ordered one today. Yeah. Let's see. Did I tear it out yet? Let's see. I think I might have. Let me see if I tore one out. Where's the characters? I might just get out my. Let me bring out my notebook here. So here's my notebook. And the first one here, let me move this. And I'll probably have to adjust the light. So y'all have to be patient. These are in page protector, so it's going to be a little bit, a glare too. The dark, which probably would have been the last one I did, should probably be the last one in here. But yeah, so here's some of the Bennett Klein ones. And these have like glitter. Hang on, let me move my Kleenex. Some have glitter on it, which I have to take it out of the sleeve for you to see. See, because it's glitter behind a page protector. There you go. See some stickles on that? Paper shouldn't tear with alcohol markers, no matter. Oh yeah, it will tear. The paper will break down and tear. Yeah, it will, because it's saturated. It's so wet. It's the wet that tears paper, not the paint or the marker. It's the wet. So yeah, you can trust me. You can tear through a piece of paper of now, not necessarily cardstock. You're not gonna sit there and go, but this paper in this book, in the Bennett Klein book here, this is like copy paper thin. This is copy paper thin. Okay, so yeah, be careful. Okay, so here is the can't. I'm trying to capture the stickle. Well, you can see. There we go. See some stickles there? All right. Let me adjust the light, guys. Since y'all want to see this, I've got to fix it now. Let's see. All right. Let's see what we can do. Let's go to right light. Okay. Water is absorbed by the wood fiber. Well, okay. Let me just say this. You may have been so careful not to get it wet enough to go through. Mine went through. I've torn a hole. But then I'm not used. I'm new to Copic, so I don't know. So yeah. So and then the clouds just painted. That's not there. I painted that. But I'm trying to see. Somebody said the dark, and I'm not sure which ones are from the dark one. So I have to, because I wrote on the back. I wrote on the back. So let's see. Let's take this one out. This one is from the sketchbook 4. We did this one on Halloween, and these have happy smiley faces in it, but I put pumpkins in there. So yeah. And then this one is from number 3. This is from book 3. And again, you can see the stickles on the fairy wings. Yeah. So, and I just painted all this. So when I tear them out, I write on the back of each sheet what book it came out of, because I'm not going to remember. Trust me, guys. I mean, the dragon ones are all dragons, but other than that, I wouldn't remember. Okay, so let's see what these two are. Think that this one's dark right there. All right, this one is out of number 4. Again, the fairy wings have got stickles, as do the little butterflies. So yeah. And then this is a little pencil, to make the bug be going. Okay, North, thank you. And yeah, so there's that one. And then this one is out of four as well. This was a bear. And again, painted all our mist and fog in ourselves, put the cloudy mist and stuff, the moon, put our own star. And then he's like a bear coming out of the mist. So there's those two. And then this one, I think, this is out of characters. I've got two more here. Two more Bennett Klein. I'm not quick on the Bennett Klein ones, guys. They're time consuming. If you really, this one was like four parts. This one, I think, was videoed four parts. She's the vampire girl, and she is dark. Yeah. So this one was dark here. It's a little out of focus, but I think you can see the colors pretty good. And then the last one is this is sketchbook one. This is out of sketchbook one. Again, I painted my own world behind it. Clouds, mist, fog, fogged up the little wings and things on the bird, made my own planets. Feathered, made the feathers look very soft. And yeah, so there's that one. And that's all my Bennett Kleins. Like I said, they take me some time, girls. Thanks. Yeah, they take some time. Alrighty, let's put this back over here. sip of coffee. All right. I think I got the bulk of it done. Got the bulk of it done. Thanks, guys. All right. So I think we're going to stop on the watercolor. If I need any more that is, the same kind of shades as the ones I've put in here, I'll just color pencil it. So yeah, we'll move that out of the way. And I didn't need to use my, I got the Jane Davenport skin tone ones, which, I plan on using maybe when we do a mermaid. We need to do a mermaid. We need to, whenever. I say that whenever we have time, we maybe do a mermaid. Yeah, because, like Z loves her mermaids. So we'll use like flesh tones there. And these are the wrappers of each one of these. I just cut the wrappers apart. So I didn't have to make my own swatch card because she gave you a card to swatch on, but I just thanks, Marilyn. I just cut the wrapper faces off and glued them on, so I didn't have to even make a swatch. You're welcome, TMT. So those are the colors in here, in the little Jane. And I know that they're sold out at Michael's now, but somebody said that they are almost, if not exact, colors to the Prima face colors. So yeah, if you can't get this one, then look, go online and get the Prima face colors. Okay, so yeah, there's that. All right, now let's make sure this is dry. I'm gonna hit it with a heat gun, then we'll adjust the lighting. Winsor & Newton watercolors are good. They've been around forever. I don't know that they're, if Daniel Smith, Schmincke's are very expensive. I think I'm pronouncing that right. So, but unless, I mean, what, trust me, Winsor & Newton are good, Mel G, for if you're just going to do what, like a mermaid or a fairy or, just paint, and if you start getting really, really good, and you want to, do more with watercolors, then upgrade. I never buy expensive stuff to start. You'll see if you like it. See if you want to do it. I don't have expensive watercolors because I've never really done. I've done a little bit. I've shown you all the boots that, you know, is one of the pieces that I have hanging on my wall. But, you know, it's my color pencil work that I do more of. Okay. All right. So let's see. Let's go ahead and, you know, I might just go ahead and tear this out because it'll probably be easier to work on. Now, you probably want to get a knife and cut it out nice, but here's what I do. I don't care if it's rough because I'm going to cut it down anyway because I trim them down to put on top of black cardstock and put inside of my book. In other words, I'll take a... Let me show you. And probably I would do it with my paper cutter so it's exact. Oh, wait. I like Prima added down... Added more Daniel Smith to the set. Okay, so Whippy has a Prima and added some Daniel Smith to her set. And Whippy says she's used Daniel Smith for over 20 years and has 80 Daniel Smith tubes. So, yeah, if y'all want to know about Daniel Smith, then Whippy be the one to ask. If y'all follow Whippy on Instagram, she posts some good stuff. She might post other places too, but that's where I see her all the time, is over on Instagram. Whippy Carroll. Okay, so again... You know, you probably want to, got a piece of tape there. Use your paper cutter, you know. I'm not that particular about it. I'm just going to trim down all the way around fairly close because I'm going to border it with a piece of black cardstock and put it in my binder, right? I'll just trim a little off here because it does have a little bit of an extra border on the bottom because the image goes off the edge. And I'll just trim this down around the edge here. If I don't get it perfectly straight, I can always just put it in the paper cutter. I'm just kind of doing this for you guys right now. Okay. And so, like here, this is my, you know, backing paper, but it's the same cardstock. So then I'll just, you know, mount it like this on a piece of... what do you call it? A black card stock, and put it in my in a sleeve. Okay, so let's go ahead and see now if we can zoom in a little. And I think I'm just gonna use my Prismas on this. I don't think I've used Prismas for a while, and you know most people are using Prismacolors to color, so I want to, you know, keep using those too. I try to rotate the pencil usage. When we did the mouse guard, we used the Lumis. In the other color book from last week, forget the exact name of it, we used the Holbies. So I kind of rotate the pencils around so that different ones get attention. We like to give the attention to the pencils. All right, so let's go ahead. Let me zoom in. We're going to zoom and we're going to refocus. I think that's pretty good. It doesn't have to be like right up on it. Let's autofocus. Let's do some right light. See, is that better light there? I think that's better. Okay, but I did, it's a little dark. I'm trying to get as accurate as I can for you guys and as focused as I can. Hopefully that's pretty good. I think that's pretty good. And I have the calendar. I'm going to move this out of the way. I have the calendar here to give it some cushion. You just want a little cushion. And my table is all crunchy, so I don't want to color directly on my table because it's crunchy. If y'all have any questions, put them in caps. You've been watercoloring mouse guard. Yeah. Burn. Yeah, this is mouse guard. And I have pictures all over the place in Mouse Guard color book. Okay. So, let's move this. Let's make some room. I'll put my paper under here just so it's a little extra cushioning. I got my pencils set aside, the ones I'm using on my current portrait. And I need some more. All right, I'm sitting on Wolfie here. Let's move Wolfie out of the way. Okay, let's still got a glare on my screen. I'm trying to tilt it and not be in the way. All right, so I think I'm going to start with the purple. I'm going to get me a couple shades of purple. I got my little paper here to test out which colors you might want. And I'll try to tell you the colors, if at all possible. No, I have a dark purple here somewhere because I just used it. We'll do a little ASMR. Okay, I've got to get out the rubber bandits because I don't have my dark purple. Want violet. Okay, I've got my little pencil sharpener in my little bowl right here. Can you believe they had, oh, I missed something. Something on the mouse guard scrolled off while I was digging for pencils. All right, let's get a nice sharp point on all of them. I'll tell you the colors that I picked, and this is just for the purple. All right, now I need some for the greens. Let's see. Sharpen this one and see what color it is. How we doing, guys? We've been here about an hour and a half. We're doing pretty good, I think, time-wise. Do y'all want to take a break and do the giveaway real quick? The weekly Monday art pack. That's going to be too brown. I don't want that green. Okay, I'm going to have to dig around here. Oops. Y'all want to do the giveaway real quick? In case people have to leave. Ready to hurt cats, yeah. We call it that, but it's really hurting cats. Well, let me get this one green real quick, guys. I need a dark green. Is this the color green I want? Do I want... Peacock green has a tint of blue to it, but it's also a good green. So maybe those three. We'll go with that for now. Might need a lighter one, though. Let me sharpen this one. Okay, so we'll go with those for now. And I need my black and my white. And some ochres, too. I think I got one ochre in here. Yeah. And I'll need a sienna. I'm going to try to tell you all the colors I'm going to use here in just a minute. It may not be the only colors I use, but I'm starting with these colors anyway. Okay. All right, so how the giveaways work, I'll talk while I'm digging. How the giveaways work is I am going to, when I type in the word go, put in a number between 1 and 100, and then I'll do random.org, and the closest, without going over, one number only. Put one number only between 1 and 100. And the closest without going over is going to get the weekly. These are like happy mail that have accumulated. Denise and I put together 42, I think. We put together 40 packs of these. And of old happy mail that I'm sharing. I don't know what's in every pack. I just pull a pack. It's taped up. I do one every Monday, and so you get what you get. I don't know what's in each pack. So that being said, if you get a pack and there's an ATC or a postcard or something in there and there's no name on it, don't ask me who sent it because I have no idea. None whatsoever. I don't even know what's in the packs. All right. Let me find my iPad here. So there's the rules. So wait for me to type in. When you see me type in, go. All right, let me find my random.org. Okay, so we know the dealio. Alrighty. So while everybody's putting in their numbers, I've got the random.org right here waiting. So I'll give everybody a minute, and I'm gonna start telling y'all the colors while we're putting in numbers. So I have violet. These are all Prismacolor. I have violet. I have, what color is this? I think it's, I don't know if it's light violet, and then lavender. So those are the three purples that I have. The greens I have are dark green, kelp green, chartreuse, and is this chartreuse? No, this is lime leaf. So those are the greens. And then a black, white, and a goldenrod, which is a yellow ochre. I mean, I have yellow ochre and goldenrods are similar. So, okay, so everybody put your number in for the next minute while I'm going to start taking the dark purple. See what I did the watercolor shading on top of the Copics? Now see how it buckled a little there from over watering. But it almost blended into the Copics. Look at that. It's almost like the Copic took over and soaked up the watercolor. See that, guys? See how it's almost gone? The watercolor, you see a little bit there, but not much. So it's like the Copic alcohol like took the color, the watercolor, because they were similar. I mean, it's not like I put, you know, red on yellow or something like that. Okay, so I think everybody's put in numbers, so I'm going to hit the stop. Get the numbers in. Get your numbers in. If you see numbers going by. It buckled a little, but that's because it was so wet. Yeah, so. You got to watch that water content. Okay, everybody got in a number? I'm going to hit the stop button. All right, so let's pick a number. Let's go here. All right, so here's our random.org. And I know it wants to flash out. I have to readjust all the light again when we're done. Okay, so I have 1 to 100. We're going to generate 28. The closest to 28. The closest to 28 without going over. Yeah, Whippy, I plan on doing some watercolor and Copic fantasy art as we go. Yeah, I sure will. 28. Who has 28? Closest to 28 without going over. Minimal bucket. Bucklage. Yes, bucklage. Yes, Terry, bucklage. J-Love? Was that Jess J-Love, Terry? I know there's a couple Jesses, so let's make sure I have the right Jess. Is it J-Love Jess? J-Love. Okay, so J-Love Jess, you get the pack of goodies. Yay! Yay you, that's right. Okay, so let's get back to our dragon here. All right, so now I'm going to go in here and start shading. I'm going to start throwing shade. I'm just going to start with a little bit around the dragon itself. Okay. In the background, I'm going over the Copic, over the watercolor test, because we just did a little watercolor test over the Copics. And now we're going to go over both. And I want this nice and sharp right here. So let's get that nice and sharp. Okay, y'all got questions, put them in caps, otherwise we're just going to roll with it. Sip a coffee. Bye, Coloring Mom. If y'all don't follow Coloring Mom, y'all need to do that. Links are open. Y'all can put your links in. That's one of the things about being in the live show. You can put in your links. I think I'll just go ahead and go all the way around it, like a little bit all the way around. Give it more definition, more border-esque, if I do that, I think. because I'm just playing here. I might put some designs in the background. You can put that on with marker as well. So I'm just wanting to blend this out. I'm no pressure, guys. No, I know I say it every show, every time. Do not put pressure on your pencil, because you won't, once the wax, or well, you know, whatever you're using, once it builds up, you can still put layer on top of layer for a certain amount of time, but your layers won't blend after you get them waxed up. I know, it is a pretty violet, isn't it? So I'm just going to I kind of think I want it all, you know, almost like a little silhouette thing here going on. I'm a thinking, and I'm a knowing. Very soft. And just kind of keep feathering it out and blending it out. Want the darkest right up next to his body. Okay? If y'all have questions, put them in caps. I don't know what Eileen says. I may be in trouble. If I used how old I am, Dee Dee would have to change the 100 numbers. Eileen. Oh my gosh, Eileen. I keep swearing I'm going to call Eileen on a Sunday, just out of the blue. Because, you know, when she was recovering, I'd call her every Sunday. Her mom would answer. And me and her mom would talk about Eileen. Alrighty. Eileen, for those of y'all that know, is our enabler elf. Whenever I say E-T-E-E, that's Eileen, the enabler elf. What did CB say? I missed what CB said. But apparently Jean's having a hissy over it. You have a new, what new color book is that, Melody? AA? I missed the title of that color book. AA? Don't know what one that is. So I'm just going to kind of give it some oomph around his little head here. Night, Marilyn. Sleep well. CB was mad because I said Eileen was older than dirt. Oh my gosh. She's not older than dirt. Not quite. Are you going to try another watercolor today, Jean? The anxiety waiting for her color. Oh, anxiety is waiting for her new color stuff and books. Ah, okay. Gotcha, Melody. Okay, gotcha. If y'all missed last week's show, I showed Melody's, Tanya, I forget the artist that did the color, but she did an awesome page with the little baby dragon. In a color book page, you know, she did the first version, and then we showed how she just added a little bit more, and it really, just adding that a little bit more, Melody, was really good. Have a close-up version. Oh, so you are going to try the Stone Angel again. Okay, Jean. Good luck. I should be there. I should be able to be there at 4. After here, now I've got some stuff to do after this. But I'll try to be there. I'll try to be there, Jean. I have to cook tonight, Jean. I gotta cook. Not too much. I think we're gonna have kielbasa sausage. I fix it the way my mother-in-law showed me. New potatoes, mashed with the skin still on them, and fried spinach in garlic butter. I think that's what we're having tonight. So, Jean, that's going to take precedent over your stream. How am I linking the pre how am I liking over the Copics? To me, it's not make it's just it's layering. It's just like it feels just like it's not no different. I mean, it's I don't even know that it really gives you any more tooth. It's going over just fine, if that's what you mean. A lot of people, Cam loves using Copics color pencil. A lot of people, lots of people use color pencils over Copics. Lots. It's not a problem at all to use Prismas over Copics. Okay, I think I need to bring this dark down just a little on this side to kind of keep it kind of balanced with that side. And I'm just taking my time and doing my light layers, like I tell you guys to do. And sometimes I get in a hurry. What I really want to do is do play with watercolor and Copic. That's what, yes, spinach and garlic and butter, yes, fried up. Doesn't it only takes a few minutes too, Eileen. And it's so good with mashed potatoes. Everything sounds good until you say spinach. I mean, it's not like canned spinach. It's actually leafy spinach, Jess. Fried in butter and garlic. It's awesome. But then I like Brussels sprouts too, so. And like fried squash, like summer squash, fried squash in butter and onions. And what you do, and y'all know I don't really cook. These things that I'm talking about is I don't even know that you consider it cooking. It's just like it's almost like heating stuff up. I mean, you stir fry something, is that cooking, I guess? Because y'all know I don't bake, I don't cook. Yeah, you cook it a lot, Eileen. And so anyway, if you take some butter, well, margarine. Actually, I found that margarine tastes better with the squash and onions than real butter. The real butter changes the flavor of the squash, which that's fine if you like it. You know, if you're used to it. I like to, I just put some margarine, crock, country crock, in the pot, in the frying pan, and slice up like onion rings. You'll slice up your onion in rings and fry it up, or put it in and start it going, and then slices of summer squash. Well, I peel the squash with a peeler and then slice it up like cucumber slices type thing and throw it all in a pan with the margarine and the onions. Put a ton of salt and pepper, fry it up. Yum. Oh, that's it. Yeah, well, and I wash all my, like, if it's a bag of spinach, Eileen, I mean, I'm like practically washing it to death before I even cook it. I know that the cooking probably anything on it, but, and because you're cooking it, but I never, never buy bag salad. Never. I do not trust bag salad because there was a scare, there was an outbreak of something a while. It's probably been a few years. There was an outbreak of something on bagged lettuce. I will never buy bagged salad. I buy everything and wash, wash, wash. Peel, peel, peel. When you're done, it puts egg and Parmesan cheese in it and fries it with butter and all. Yeah, that sounds good. Yeah. I love squash that way too. Yeah, Carole Renee, isn't it good? I know. I have grown my own summer squash before. It's been a while. I don't have time to, y'all know, guys. I do my gardening every year. I put out my tomatoes, some peppers, some herbs. What else do I put out there? One year I did some strawberries. But, I have my square foot garden, if you will. It's four railroad ties and built up. Every year I get about 10 bags of dirt, build it up, I should compost. Don't have time for that. I mean, I'm lucky if I can throw some what do you call it? Coffee grounds out there every now and then. Yeah, I make my own. Okay, so there you go. So there's kind of like it kind of almost could use just like maybe just a little darker. And I gotta say, guys, I'm spending more time chatting with you than I am concentrating on this, which is a bad thing if you're watching the recording. We're not getting very far, are we? This will probably be a two-parter. I've been trying like the mouse guard. We did get that page done in one day, But, you know, it's hard to get this done in 3 hours. We'll keep going for, you know, 2 hours and 45 minutes or whatever and see how far we get. But, you know. And it was, yeah, exactly. So that's why I wash everything. And the thing about spinach, if I'm cooking it, you know, you're less likely to have any kind of, you know, germs on that or disease or whatever if you cook it. But you don't cook just, you know, just lettuce. You cook the spinach. At least I do. I don't eat it just raw, you know, plain. I cook it up. Or, well, Hubster does most of the time. So, all right, let's keep going here around these little other parts here. Let me sharpen my pencil again. And I just want to just, you know, get a little bit of shading in each one of these little areas. Doesn't take much. See, it just gives it a little more depth. All about the depth in our coloring. Bye, Charlie. Thanks for stopping in. And all you lurkers out there, thanks for being here. See, I'm just putting a little bit in there, and I'm going to go in there and blend with another shade, a purple. Probably this one. But I want to first get... I want it nice and dark around the dragon itself. We haven't done any scales yet or anything. Am I zoomed in close enough for you guys? Yeah, hopefully. And again, I could have probably, you know, had another Copic color and done this with that. You know, shaded two colors. But I want to get, you know, a little bit more proficient at it before I start, you know, trying too much blending and stuff. And it, you know, just doing a little here and a little there, and y'all can just go learn along with me. Cam's been giving me some tips. He's excited for me to do Copics because he does them, right? He does them, so he's all about Nana doing it, too. How do you cook the sausage? Oh, like my mother... Rebecca, well, it's probably nothing fancy, and maybe y'all all do this, so I don't know. But it's just the way she told me to do it, because I used to just, like, slice it. You know, you get it in the package, right? And I'd take it out of the package, and most, you know, fry it. I would just, like, cut it in four. Okay, like, here's the sausage. Like, the sausage is, like, in a pack like this, right? And I would, like, just cut it like this and slice it and fry it. But my mother-in-law boils it first. So she cuts it into, you know, three or four, however much, you know, just sausage length, you know, doesn't slice it. She just cuts it, puts it in the, and boils it for about 10 minutes. Then takes it out of the boiling water and then slices each one in half and fries it on both sides. And it just tastes so much better. I'm not sure why. I'm not sure why it tastes better than just frying it, but boiling it and frying it, it just tastes better. It's like it brings out the flavors. It has flavor. And then my mom, the thing that I make of hers, I'm not a cook, guys. I don't very rarely don't cook. I mean, I know how to do stuff, but I just don't, you know, is my mom's potato salad. I make an awesome potato salad, and it's all based on my mommy. So, Mom, if you're watching, thanks for your potato salad recipe. Y'all want to know how I make that? I'm just shading and talking. I've shown y'all how I cook. I've shown you my art pictures of food. That's how... Yes, I do use fresh garlic. I smash it between two spoons because I don't have a garlic press. I can. I just take two spoons and smash it up between two spoons. But yes, it is fresh garlic. What did BG, beloved ghost say? I missed something that BG said. It scrolled off. Oh, wait. Something too said. You're never eating. You're never eating again? Ah, Jerry, why? Why? Why do you say that? I make awesome potato salad. The secret is to cook the potatoes with the peelings, and it depends on the well, maybe if you cook it and just till the skins fall off, Jean. I cook new potatoes, you know, the red potatoes with the skins on. But my regular, like baking potatoes, like russet Idaho potatoes, that's what I make my potato salad with. And I peel them. I do peel my potatoes, that particular one. Before, I don't do the skins on, I do the different kind of potatoes for my potato salad. I use the russet Idaho potatoes for my potato salad. Yeah, I use the potatoes, cook them, and then like let's just say I have a big pot of potatoes. I'm not sure, you know, like a big pot of potatoes. I'll also add probably at least 6 to 8 hard-boiled eggs. So I boil the eggs in one pot, boil the potatoes in the other pot. The secret to me to making a good potato salad is you got to cool the potatoes before you make the potato salad. Otherwise, it's mushy. You have to allow yourself enough time. Whatever ingredients you put in your potato salad, you have to have the potatoes cold. You have to have the potatoes cold. Yeah, I don't make potato salad with the red potatoes. I like mashed potatoes with the spinach, with the red potatoes, with the skins. But my potato salad is just made with regular potatoes. Yeah, like just probably the same thing as like Whippy saying Yukon Gold potatoes. You know, just like, you know, regular old brown potatoes. But you have to, after you boil them and you can stick a fork in them and they're done, I dump them into a colander and then put them in the refrigerator to cool. You know, you wait about an hour is all it takes. You got to let them cool. Because if you don't let your potatoes cool, well, I guess I need to keep working here. If you don't let your potatoes cool, then it's a mushy potato salad. And so then I use that, my half a dozen eggs. Coffee and cooking with tea. Oh, don't get that rumor started, Beth. Seriously. I only make my potato salad for special occasions. Like if we have a picnic or go on the lake, or Denise is coming over because Denise and the kids love my potato salad. And again, it's all my mom's recipe. And I don't measure anything. It's all eyeballed. So I got the potatoes. I'll keep working here, guys. I have the potatoes and the eggs, both cooled, cut down into chunks. You got to leave it kind of chunky or it's mushy. Then I use mayonnaise and mustard. I like Mount Olive pickles, dill pickles, it doesn't have to be Mount Olive. That's just my favorite dill pickle. And I usually just use the slices because I like the slices just to munch on. So I just usually use a half a jar of pickles. And what I'm talking about, I'm making a lot here, guys. I'm making a lot of potato salad. No, I don't put black olives in mine. A lot of people don't like black olives, so I don't. Now, the grands love black olives, but I don't put it in a potato salad. So I have the potatoes, a bunch of eggs, chopped up onion, chopped up dill pickle, mustard, mayonnaise, a little splash of pickle juice, just a little. Not much, because then you'll get it mushy again. Salt, pepper, and I think mom puts paprika. I don't put paprika, but other than that, I think that's it. Eggs, onions. It's very simple. It's very basic. Yes, I put the dill pickle juice in the potato salad. Yeah. And that's it. It's simple, guys, but it tastes so awesome. I think the mine, I had a little bit more mustard than your average potato salad. So it's a little, the potato salad's a little on the yellow side. And you have that little, and it's just French's mustard. You have that little mustard bite, you know? That's kind of, and that's how mom makes it too. And so that's, yeah, it's nothing to it really, but it's awesome. Tastes great. It's so easy to make. Yeah, I don't put relish. I just put chopped up pickles, chopped up onions. I'm trying to think if there was anything else. It seems like there should be, but there's not. Eggs. Mayonnaise, mustard, salt, pepper. And again, I don't measure any of this. I eyeball it all. The salt, the pepper, all of it. I just eyeball it, take a taste, and we're good to go. Okay, so I think we got that. All right, so I'm trying to see if there's any dark purple. Okay, so now let me go down here and sharpen my pencil. I'm gonna put a little shade in these flowers. You have a spoonful of sugar. Yeah, see, I like Vicky said that she has a spoonful of sugar. I like a little on the mustardy bite side rather than a sweet side. Everybody off to cook now? Okay, so I'm just going to put a little of the dark purple right along the. Can y'all see? See how that makes a difference? Look, see just that little bit of dark purple there. And I'm going to blend all the purple out, but let me just get this. I want to get a little bit on the dragon because I know we're not going to finish this, especially with me gabbing about cooking. I'm just going to turn it upside down here to get these sides. Jean says, have any of you had beet salad? It's mashed potatoes with mayo and finely diced onion and diced beets and mat up. Oh, world off, Jean. I missed the rest. But the answer is no. I don't know anybody in our family that likes beets. I don't know one single person in our family that likes beets. Now you're craving some homemade potatoes. It doesn't take any time at all. And I could go whip some up, you know. If I have, as long as I have an onion in there, I don't know. But doesn't take long at all. But I anyway, so yeah, I'm gonna have the sausage tonight. This is how we started the conversation. I'm having the boiled and fried sausage. I'm gonna have the new potato, mashed potatoes, and fried spinach. That's what I'm having for dinner. So I said all that to say that I might be late to your house tonight, Jean, to your show. Jean comes on at 4. And if I want to have it all done by, 5:30, I'll get it all going and everything. I might have to take Lappy down to the kitchen, Jean. But I got some other things to do after my show. Because I'm, yeah. My weekend got shot with so much things going on and work. Potato salad and grilled cheese. Yeah, we could have that, Whippy. I could whip both those up. But you have to give me 24-hour notice if you want potato salad. Otherwise, you just show up, you're getting grilled cheese and pickles and chips. That's all you're getting. Unless y'all want to go down the street to Chick-fil-A. Those are your options. Or we could go to the grocery store. I have a Publix right down the street, too, and you can pick your own stuff and make it. Okay, so there we go. There's a. All right, so now I'm gonna let me just test the medium purple, okay? Because I have the light, I have the lavender too. So let me just kind of look at both. It might just need the lavender. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna go with the lavender because that'll just blend. So all I want to do now is just kind of do a little bit of blend. I don't have to do the whole thing. I can see where the pencil marks are. And I don't use blender pencils. I mean, I have, but I don't normally use blender pencils. I don't use any of the mineral spirits or baby oil, none of that. I don't gesso my pages. I don't spray my pages. I don't fixative my pages. And I don't varnish my color book pages. It is what it is. But if you ever do decide to spray varnish or, I mean, a spray seal or anything, make sure you test. Like if you've put watercolor or something that's reconstitutable, you want to make sure that whatever you're spray fixating or anything you coat it with is not going to move. So you want to test all that. Okay. See, you probably can't even see. I mean, I can tell where I've blended the pencil with the lavender, but it's really not showing up on camera that I can tell. But do I do windows? You know what? I don't mind cleaning. I don't mind cleaning at all. I don't mind cleaning, laundry, and of course I don't really iron anymore. But growing up, I grew up ironing my dad's military uniforms with starch and everything. So, I never minded ironing. I would trade ironing with my sisters if they would do the dishes or clean up after dinner. I would iron. I'd rather iron that of all the chores. But I don't mind cleaning. I really don't mind cleaning. I'd much rather clean than cook. If I could have someone cook and I do their cleaning, we're good. So I do, and the hubster and I share the cleaning. We'll both do laundry and, it's just the two of us. It's not like this house ever gets, we'll do that spring cleaning thing every couple weeks where we really dig in and, vacuum and get the bathrooms not, and stuff like that. But, we pick up after ourselves. We do the dishes after we eat. The dishes are done. So there's no dirt, no dirty dishes in the kitchen in the morning, because just two of us, right? Yeah, I do not mind cleaning at all. And, of course, I have a dishwasher too, but I've organized girls' scrapbook rooms before for them. I had one friend that I helped her two or three times reorganize her scrapbook room. This is back when, we all had scrapbook rooms, if you want to call it that. All right, Bunny, thanks for stopping in. But yeah, I love organizing. And Hubster always teases me when I come out. So I think I'm going to go organize my art space. He goes, "Yeah, you need to do that. You need to get organized." Because he knows I'm always, I always after a stream or between projects, everything's put away. I just can't do the next thing. Like I have to work on my portrait of Kenny's granddaughter again. I got to get back to this, right? Well, before I can do that, I have to finish my stream, up, put all my pencils away, start my upload on my videos, and clean off my desk, eat some lunch before I start that. And I still have other things to do before I can even get to that. So, I have to have it all ready to go for the next thing before I start the next thing. I pretty much dust with a Swiffer. I mean, I do have some glass top tables that I take Windex to, but and that is probably the thing that gets the dirtiest around here is the it gets dusty because we leave our windows open a lot, so we get a lot of dirt dust on furniture. Yeah, well, I don't iron Hubster's clothes anymore. He takes them to the cleaners. I don't have time to do that anymore. I don't have time to do it. He can take it to get someone else to, starch and, do his clothes. I mean, we do our laundry, don't get me wrong, but his like nice his dress shirts he wears to work or khaki pants or anything like that, they all go to the cleaners. I don't do all that anymore. I don't mind ironing, but I don't have the time for it anymore. Don't have the time for that anymore. And of course, the kids, they grew up learning how to do all this stuff. I grew up in the military. They grew up in the military. We all, you learn to do stuff early. Boo and Cam were, cooking and ironing and stuff young. When, because Denise grew up doing it young. So therefore, they learned how to do it young. We learned how to do it young. Yeah, I know people are allergic and that dust bothers, I'm sure. I'm not talking about. Everybody, has different situations, but all right, I'm gonna sharpen this again. So yeah, and if you move 30 times in your life, you learn to do a lot of things, including change jobs every 2 or 3 years. So I probably had as many jobs, well, probably not as many jobs as moving, but I've had a lot of jobs because you move, you gotta go get something else, get another job. Because I always worked when we were raising the kids. Had to. Military don't pay nothing. Still probably doesn't much. So if you're in the military and you're watching this or you're a military family, shout out. Shout out to you guys, whatever branch you're in. Jean says you had home economics teacher. And mommy learned how to cook. Yeah, we had home ec too in high school, Jean. I took sewing because I didn't want to cook. And I didn't like sewing either. And that's probably the only time I've ever sewn. Grandma sewed and made a lot of our clothes when we were in like elementary school. But yeah, didn't like sewing. Never liked sewing. Someone said the other day they use baby wipes to dust and it picks up all the dust and none of it flies. Yeah, I guess you could do that, but it's going to leave streaks of water or stuff on your furniture, on your glass, or on your wood or whatever. I guess it maybe use the natural care so it doesn't have scented stuff. I don't know. I guess it depends on your wood, your glass, whatever. Okay. I think I did all those flowers and the purple. So can y'all see here? Need a little bit more blending here, right next to the dragon's head, because I got it real dark right there, and I want to kind of blend that out a little. The little flower centers. Meerkat loves cooking and baking. My daughter Annie in LA, she loves to bake. She makes some cool stuff. And she finds the coolest stuff on Pinterest to make. Like she did a little gummy bear. Of course, my grandson out there is like 7, or he's almost 7. I think he's almost 7. Makes these cool like cupcakes with gummy worms and like little creatures like Walking Dead things. I mean, she does all kinds of real entertaining kind of stuff. Like if she goes to parties and things, she'll bring cool things that she's made, baked and stuff like that. Your hubby's a Navy vet. Aw, Terry, yeah. My husband is Army vet and well, Army, yeah, vet, retired. And my dad was Air Force. So. Yee said to her, it's still 4 months till retirement. Well, thank you for all that y'all have done, Yee. I totally get it. I totally get it. All right, so let's see now. Because I am going to want to do, I'm thinking maybe a glitter gel pen for scales. It doesn't show up in a photograph, but you guys would get, think it was cool. But let's go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and get the lightest green here. And let me do a little test on his head here. Let's see, is that going to be light? And oh, that's not going to be the right thing. You know what I think I'm going to do? Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a Posca, the white Posca for the scales and the detail, and I'm going to put white Posca, which is just white acrylic paint. And the reason I'm going to use white is because then I can take my light greens, okay, and like just kind of brush over that white dried Posca and have it light. Phoebe says afraid of the sewing machine. Okay, so let's go ahead and do the little light in his eye here. And again, I'm going to go over that with, I'm going to do all this after it dries. I'm going to do a like a light. You could do a wash over it too, but I'm going to do pencil. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to find areas to go in here with white. All right, so can you see that? And I'm going to go in here with every little scale. Every scale I'm going to touch with the white. It doesn't take long if you get on a roll. You got to kind of get on a roll. There's around the eye there. Because what this will do, and we're going to also, we can add some more dark green as well. Your hubs is retired Air Force. Yeah, I grew up in San Antonio, CB. Yeah. My mom and family still live there. Still live in San Antonio. And I have an aunt and uncle in my home state, but we grew up in San Antonio. Little kids, I mean, Since then, I've moved all over, but yeah. Mare has a sewing machine. Can't identify any of the parts. Are there proper names? Me either, Mare. I mean, I would watch, I'd watch Today's Show, planks, fried spinach, garlic, yummy, yeah. I'd watch Grandma sew, and she'd make all our little doll clothes and things. But, and our clothes when we were in, elementary school. I didn't mind sitting watching her sew, but I had really no desire to sew. I was arting, right? Reading and arting. Those were my hobbies. And I like swimming. I did like swimming. Diving. I did some diving. Had no fear. I would just dive. I would do flips off the high dives and all that stuff. Yes, you do understand the moving bit. Yeah. Okay, so I'm just coming in here and I'm just touching all the different. Now, I'm even doing the purple, that's the big scales along his back, because I'll go over that with light purple. But I really want to concentrate mostly on all the little tiny scales, okay? Even if I just touch them with the dot. And they are getting a little tricky to see. I gotta look down my nose at the at this. Because it's tiny and I gotta, find that sweet spot on the trifocals. So I'm not looking at chat for just a minute. And I'm kind of making almost little U shapes. But they're so tiny, they're probably just going to look like dots to you. But they are kind of little U shapes, but very tiny. Because they're the little scales, right? There's another. Then his little scale on his back here. And this is just so I can go over it with a highlight. All right, so see? See where I've, well, that's kind of a little mess right there. Let me go fix his little neck. And get his little scales going a little wonky. A little wonky. See how it already looks like it's going to be scales, even though right now they're white. I'm going to let it sit for a minute, or I can hit it with the heat gun. And I'm just going to go over the whole thing with the light green. Well, not rub it down because I'm going to have dark in there too, but I'll put the dark after that. Well, not quite pointillism, but yeah. What size is the Posca? It is, I think it's not the finest one according to Jean. Jean has all kinds of ones. Seven? I think it's 7 millimeter. It's so tiny. Let me get my, where's my, yeah, 0.7. 0.7, and it's a new point, right? So it's real pointy, but they start to wear down, and I use them quite a bit, so they do wear down. So yeah. Okay, so I'm going to do these back scales where it's purple, because I'll go over that, but I'm just kind of finding my where I want a little bit brighter down his back. And again, the reason I'm using white is because I can put any color over it. I was hoping to get this done today so I could post it on the Bennett Klein Facebook page. If y'all do Bennett Klein coloring at all, you need to be in the Bennett Klein Facebook page. Everyone over there is so nice. I know Laura is, I don't know if Laura's still here, but she can attest to how nice everybody is. Okay, so now. Because Laura calls Bennett Klein her boyfriend. In a joking way, guys. Let's don't get any rumor started. And Bennett Klein sent me one of his sketches, and it's just, he's always shouts out every week. He shouts out somebody that's really a part of the community, and he does a freebie every Friday. And leaves it up for a couple days so you can print it out. You can buy his digital downloads or the hard copy. Now, the paper is thin. I'll grant you that. The paper in his books is thin. But yeah. So, don't get it thinking it's going to be some like watercolor paper, people, because it's not. It's thin. But because he does the digital downloads and all that, you can print it out on any kind of paper you want. If that's an issue, I try to color it right off the directly off the page. Although, like I said earlier, I am going to, let me find this way here. I am going to print off one on craft cardstock, and color it all in black and white, only black and white pencil, on craft cardstock. So when I go fire up the printer later today, I will print off one or two, and on craft cardstock, and color it in black and white only. Now, I don't know that I'll film it. I might have to just do that, like, you know, after I go to bed and I got a black and white pencil in my hand or something. We'll see. But, yeah. Your virtual boyfriend, yeah. I know Carol Renee's in the group. Who else here? Can y'all, let's give Bennett Klein a shout out. So anybody here that's, we have over 100 people. So anybody that's here that's in the Bennett Klein sketchbook on, Color My Sketchbook on Facebook, his group, let me know and we'll shout out. Just say me. Carol Renee, Laura, which is Anxiety Art Adventures. Y'all need to follow her on YouTube. Anxiety Art Adventures. Who else here? I think Bunny, aren't you? Bunny, aren't you in it? So, Beloved Ghost is in. I'm just kind of waiting to see. Hey, DeMonte, who else is in the Bennett Klein Facebook Color My Sketchbook is the name of it. Bennett Klein Color My Sketchbook. CB, Angie Bell, Terry, Carrie is too. Yeah, Carrie's not here right now, but Carrie's in it. Yeah. I know Carrie will comment. She's so nice to everybody, our iCarrie love. Terry A, Kathy Kaberg, Dragonfly 8, Marie LaVie. Some of y'all are naming people that are in his group that aren't here today. Whippy Carroll. What happened, Jean? Did I miss something? I saw something about your storm. And that's all I saw. The other... Oh, yeah, okay. Mountain Dreamer Teresa, Miss Kim Smith, Crafting Amy, Yee, Barb W. So almost everybody here is in it that colors. Yeah, Little P is in. Almost everybody here that colors is in the Bennett Klein Facebook group. Suzanne says she's in it, but she hasn't submitted anything. Well, girl, and you may, you know, it does, no, it's no kidding, guys. It does take a while to color these Bennett Kleins. Jean says you're going to bag 2 feet of snow today, Jean? Oh, my gosh, girl. Are you going to bet? You still going to stream today? I mean, of course, if you're, something happened to your electricity or something, I understand that. But, I mean, barring that, you still going to stream? Everybody, yeah. Well, you know, you're not coloring in Bennett Klein right now, Jean. But if you were, I'm sure you'd be in the group. So, yeah. I got to be careful not to set my sleeve on the... Where it dries pretty almost immediately, but okay, you are okay. Thanks, Jean. Just wanted to make sure. I got to plan my dinner around your schedule. All right, so you can kind of see where I'm just kind of doing some dots where it ends up at the very tips, and then it's just going to be just enough to give it a highlight. And I'd like to do, and we'll see how much time we have, is I'd like to put a tiny little shadow under each one of these. So, but I'll put the light lavender over the white, and then I'd like to go in there and shadow, because every one of these is its own little, it's not really a scale. I guess it's a scale. It's each one of those is its own little shape. I know, it's awesome, isn't it? And so I'm probably going to want a shadow under each one of those, but you know, it does take time when you want to have a realistic looking dragon. So I'm just trying to follow it here down the edge. This is one of his fins, or not fins, well, kind of call it a fin. Thanks, guys. We're getting there. It's slow going when you got tiny bits, right? All right, so I'm going to put a little bit of... And let's see from the tail here. These little scales. And he's got some little flippy things there. A couple other little scales. I'm just kind of trying to follow the different shapes that are in his back fins or back scales. But like, let me let this dry. Not that's kind of a big space that'll be able to show you exactly where I'm going with this. Let's see, where else do I have any more? Oh, yeah, I do. I got more right in here. His little, here's his claw. Let's give his claw a highlight. Sip of coffee. Give his claw a little highlight. Now I feel a sneeze coming on. Okay, and his little foot here, because I haven't even done, you know, any of his body here. I haven't done any of the down the back where the green is. I kind of just started with the purple now. I miss what Eileen said. That's a lot of dotting. Yes, it is. But, you know, if you want it to look like what's in your head, you gotta take the time to do it. And really, this is going to be quicker than you think once I get to the pencil. You know, I mean, not that it has to be fast. I mean, you know. Okay, what else? There's some little scales back in there. I haven't even done any of these big scales yet. Know what I mean, Vern? I won't do the whole thing because I don't want to run out of time. Yeah, we got about 15 minutes. Sometimes it's kind of, Ustream can kind of cut off, you know, at an hour and a half. Sometimes you can go three. I don't know what deciding factor is. I mean, I can start another part. That's not a problem. But in one segment, you can have between 2.5 to 3 hours. But you never know exactly. It's like, got to be on your toes. Yeah, well, the white Posca, I'm going over the white Posca in a minute with pencil. So it's not going to be white for long. But it helps you, it brings it out, right? So I still got all these tiny little scales here. Very tiny. I got to look down the bridge of my nose and find that focus spot there. All right, I won't go down the whole body here because this is going to take a while. By a while, I mean probably 5 minutes, but. All right, what else? Okay, I think I got enough here to give you the idea, right? It's the idea. Do you prefer the acrylic washes or the watercolor washes? You know, it doesn't really matter. I like them both. It doesn't, you know. I don't know that it's this. To me, it's almost exactly the same, to tell you the truth. You have to be less careful about your translucency with watercolor. If you use acrylics, you just got to make sure they're watered down enough that you still see through it, right? But the feel of it with the pencil on top, it's almost, I can't really tell a difference. Maybe there's a tiny, you know, there's more, a little bit more tooth with acrylic. There is. But it's not so noticeable in a color book page. You know, it's just really not that different. I think you can just use whatever, whichever. All right, so now what I'm going to do, oh wait, did I miss some little scales here in the wing. Did I get all the rest? Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my light purple here, and I'm just going to kind of, I can't really, I'm going to show you, and I'm going to set it down. So see where the white is? So now what I'm going to do, let me sharpen my pencil. And it's best if you kind of just go over each one rather than just color the whole thing, because I don't want to just like, I don't really want to color the whole thing, because I want to have enough, enough layering capabilities with the dark. So I'm just going to kind of just almost just like color over each dot. And I'm not bearing down. It does, you don't need to. You'll see, I'll hold it up here where it's halfway done. You don't need to bear down because you're, it's going on just fine. Okay, so I'm going to do a couple little areas of the wing here. All right, so let's see if you can see the difference. See how far I've gone right to there, and then there it's white. It's very subtle. Okay, it's very subtle. But it's just not white. It's purple. Light purple instead of white. But to get that bright purple like that, that's why I put the white Posca down. Okay, let's go a couple of this. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the darker, and some areas where you can really maybe notice it, I will add some shading with the violet, like the dark, dark purple. And I'll do the same exact thing with a light and dark green, because the mid-tone is what we got already on there. I hope I'm making sense. All right, so let's see if you can see. See where that's now purple here? All right, so see where there's purple and there's white. See the difference? Here's white. Here's it with the purple on top. See the difference? Here I got the purple here, and I'm going to do some green for you in a minute. All right, so now what I'm going to do is take the violet, the dark purple, okay, and I'm going to put a little bit of shadow under each one that I can get into. And you got to have a nice sharp pencil to do this, because you're going to kind of flick it in there, flicking some shadows. And I keep turning my pencil to keep a sharp edge. See? Right there? Let me do these little scales right here, because that'll probably be really obvious. But you probably want to do the white and the go over the white before you put the shadows in. And I'll tell you why, because if you put the shadows in first and then try to go on, you might be just kind of smearing it in. You might lose that bright. You might lose your bright white that has the layer over it if you start going over it. So I put this little last little shadow touch in here after the fact. I think that probably work better, but test it yourself. You know, it depends on how much layering you're doing. Sharpen again. Nice sharp pencil, because I want you to see the difference between the two here. Oops, see, I'm trying to get too sharp. Just gives it that little bit of, heard something out the door. So thanks, everybody. Oh, did we do all the giveaways? Yeah, we did the giveaways. Okay, I think, did we do our giveaways today? We did. So thanks, everybody, for being here. If you're watching the recording on YouTube, thanks for watching over there. And all you guys here in the live chat. Find a couple more dark bits. All right, so let's see if you can tell the difference. All right, so here's just with white. Well, here's with just white. Here's with the over the top with the lavender, and then in between with the dark. Can you see? Maybe it's better that right there. Now let's do a little with the greens. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take the dark. Wait, no, whoa, whoa, whoa. Let's take the light green. I'm going to take the chartreuse, I think. And I'm going to do this. Oh, hang on, guys. Did I get it sharpened? Okay, so now I'm going to go over just the same thing that I just did with the purple. I'm going to do the same thing on top of the green scales. And just going over each little white scale thing here. Now I haven't even done anything with these big scales yet. I wanted to show y'all this process here. Somebody's tweeting me. Hang on, whoever's tweeting me. I'll check it after we're done. And I'm just going over each little dot to get it green. Let's see if I can find a place where maybe right down here you'll be able to see it better. Let me pick up my. Let me do my purple on the claw here. The light purple on top of the white. Here's a couple more spots here that I missed. Back to the green. All right, so there. See? And now I can go in there with the dark green and start like maybe under that wing, it's a little extra dark. And then just kind of roll it out between the scales here. It's very tiny. You gotta have a, sharp pencil in a minute. Sharp pencil in a minute. So I don't know that I'll finish this today. I might finish it tonight. Lay in bed and watch it or something. I don't do my portraits at night. I mean, it's just too hard to see the exact shades of skin tones on portraits. But I can color. I mean, it's not, it's like this is not, color's not changing. I'm not blending, really. I mean, I'm blending like that, but I'm not blending like a blue, a yellow, and a skin tone. So, but it's hard for me to do portraits at night, even with the daylight bulbs I have in here. It's hard to see skin tones in the I like just like window light, Okay. I like me some window light. All right, so now can you see how we added some dark green in there? And these are just the little. I haven't done any dark green here, so you can see. Here's no dark green, here's dark green. All right, so now I'm going to get in here on this one and just kind of go in between each one, maybe a little shadow under that little flared piece on his leg. But I want to get back on my little cutest little girl. Well, I say cutest, but no one's cuter than mine. In my, you're with you're the Nana. No grandchild is as cute as yours. But she's cutie. What I'm working on. Okay, so can y'all see that? See the little foot there? And if you get some that looks a little too bright, take your darker green and knock it back. If you get some white dots that look like they're just really too, still too bright, you can go in there and start shading back. Now that you got your dark in there, you don't have to worry about losing that. So, shade around there, maybe a little under that one. So now I'm just kind of going in here with the dark green over the areas of the dragon that are green, adding a little bit more shading here and there. Can y'all see? I mean, I like it. Honestly, not gonna be for everybody. But I like the dramatic effect of it. And I think when the whole dragon is done, that's going to look really cool, you know? What do y'all think? So let me just go ahead and test real quick on the yellow ochre. Here I'm going to do a couple little, a little shading on the little, I know there's little cone, pine cone, pineapple. You know, it's kind of like, I don't know what those called. It's not, I don't think it's a leaf. Maybe they're called leaves. The little cone things, whether it's a pine cone or a pineapple. So just doing a little bit of shading in there. Can y'all see? Yeah, you can see the difference. See the difference between that and that? See how much richer and more depth that is? You're loving the green and the purple. Thanks there, Jess. Is it Jess or Laura? Yeah, Jess. So now I'm just gonna make maybe a little shadow under the where the little edges are there. And this is just with one color on top of the watercolor. You can add another shade of yellow ochre. Just this one, you see? But you see how doing it this way with a wash? Doing it this way with the wash, see how I don't have to even do anything right there? That, see that line right there? That's, it's hard to see on camera, but that's yellow. That's a yellow ochre color. Same thing for that and that line right there. I don't have to try to highlight that. It's already highlighted for me by just the wash over the whole thing. So now I just got to go in there and shade under each one of those little leaves, if you will. And it doesn't take any time at all. You go back in there with a secondary shadow, I mean a secondary color to make it even darker. Anything say, put it in caps. We're about ready to wrap up. And if the recording does stop while I'm working, I thank you again if you're watching on YouTube for watching the recordings. Again, this is a live show with a live audience, chatty ones, including myself. We are chatty. But it's got some tooth to it from the watercolor. So I'm not working on like slick paper. You know? Hey, Diane. Thanks for being here. You know, just that little bit of watercolor or acrylic, whatever you use to put a wash on with, it gives it enough tooth that your pencil's not like sliding like it would on just a piece of cardstock. It just has enough of a little grain, if you will, a little tooth. That you're able to really, you know, work it. Work it, girl, work it. So I may or may not finish this off camera. If I finish it off camera, I'll show it to you, but you got the idea. I would like to show you how to maybe do some of these scales, how I plan on doing them. I probably will want to get in between each one. I'm going to want to get a little bit of shadow every place that they connect. I'm just going to kind of touch. Just a little bit. So every place they touch, I'm going to put a little, and along the edge here too. I'll show you the, I want to do a few for you just so you know in case I do go ahead and finish this off camera. You can kind of see where I'm going with it. Well, I doubt if I'll finish it off camera. I still got to do the borders and all that. So it'll probably be a little bit worked on during another show, but we'll see. All right, so let's just, I'm going to just kind of get in there in between. It'll get blended out even more. It's not going to be a harsh line, but I just want you to kind of see how you can get in there with the dark. Because these are big enough where I'll just go in here with some pencil, I think. If it got too dull, I could go in there again with Posca if I needed to. But these bigger scales, I think I can manage some shading. Okay, so see, here's without anything but the wash. See, I'm starting to go in there and start shadowing in between the scales. Just a little touch. Just a little touch in there. All right, now let's see how, if I take my lightest green here. Yeah, see, it's not quite, I think I'm going to go with a white. Then I can go over the white. Yeah, because this has got color, you know, a wash on it, you can go over the top with your pencil. I'll show you here in a minute. Let's see. So I'm just going to put a little highlight on each one. And some of the tiny, tiny ones, it's hard to even get in there with a pencil. That you might need to get in there with a Posca. But I think I can get in there pretty well. So I'm just putting a little white on each one. Because I'm going to kind of shade a circle almost. Just imagine, you know, kind of shading around it. Because I think that'll make it pop out. You could shade it like if the sun was hitting it a certain way. But I'm just going to do each one. And I haven't got those. All right, so, all right, let's see if I can show you this real quick. Because I think we're about to run out of time. All right, so see how I put some white? See the difference now between that and that? See how it's already starting to have some depth to it? Now I'm going to take my medium green. No, I'm going to still take my dark green. I'm going to start kind of doing a little bit of, I'll do a few here. Because I think this is going to look cool when I go blend it with the medium green. I think they're going to kind of stand out a little bit. Pop those scales off the page. You're welcome, North. I'm glad you had a good afternoon. Thanks for being here. Appreciate all the newbies and the lurkers. We love the lurkers, too. Nothing wrong with just sitting back and watching other people's shows. I do it occasionally. I try to be a little bit in the chats. But, you know, when I'm watching someone else's, sometimes I'm really in the chat, like a Jeans, but sometimes it's, you know, you can't chat. Sometimes there's issues. Sometimes you don't want to chat. You just want to watch and watch, do your own work. So we love our lurkers. We'd love for you to not be a lurker so we could, you know, meet you and grill you. I mean, ask you polite questions. And you don't have to do it as fast as I'm doing it. I'm just kind of hurrying so you can get an idea what it's going to look like. But don't rush it. Take your time. Now I'm going to take the light medium green here, and I'm going to start kind of blending it around. Just almost kind of like making little circles around the white. And kind of just a little bit into the white there. You can almost just go completely over the white, actually. Because it's, I don't really want it white. I want them green, but I wanted them to pop off the page a little. And you can just continue to add darker and lighter, because these are bigger areas, so you have more real estate to color on, right? And then, especially like around along the edge here, where the purple edge comes, meets the green, I want it to have almost like a little edge to it so it really stands out. Because I haven't even done this one yet. Let's do this one real quick. Let's do this edge right here. At least with the light color. I need to go in there with the shadow too. And I'm picking up my pens, kind of like picking up and just kind of coloring each one of those little white dots. Oh, mailman. All right, So just so you can see where I'm going to add the dark. Because I'm going to go along here, sharpen again. What color are you using for the shadows? I'm using the darker of the colors. Like I'm using, this is dark green for the green areas and violet for the purple areas. I said the colors at the beginning. It's like lavender, three shades of purple, including lavender and dark and violet, and then dark green, chartreuse, and I think lime or something. So both the top and the bottom here. And if you don't feel like you can get in there with a sharp pencil, you know, maybe that's where you need to, you know, get in there with a gel pen or a pen, or even a, you could probably even get in there with your bullet tip Crayola markers. But remember, those are water-based. So if you do go in there with some of your water-based markers, just remember that that's on there and it can reconstitute and get wet again. So just be aware. So just kind of take your time and kind of just get in between every little scale. I'm getting hungry. What time is it? It's almost 12. We're getting ready to, yeah, we're at a 2:47. So I think I'll just go ahead and stop this, guys. And thank everybody for being here. Okay, so here we go. This is what it looks like with just the wash. This is what it looks like with, and again, I know the colors are probably a little, and you can go in there and you could even do some little, like, roughness to it. Like maybe some of these larger ones, put a little extra texture on them like that and kind of blend that in just to give it a little bit more, I don't know, texture. Say you go in there with some, do the odd texturing. Do the odd texturing here and there on top of everything just to give it some more texture. Well, they are kind of look like rocks. Yeah. That's kind of what the scales look like to me. That's what they look like. I just want them to have a lot of depth. Yeah, you just do your own thing. Do your own thing. If you don't like them like this, work out a solution. You can do it. I like the way that looks, though. They look bumpy. You know, kind of like, you know how a troll looks? Yeah, y'all, everybody's seen a troll, right? You know how bumpy the trolls look? That's kind of the look I wanted, you know. I didn't just want them flat. I didn't just want them flat scales. If you wanted to overlap them, though, okay, if you want them to look like they were overlapping, let me show you that, okay? So what you would do is you could shade under each one here, like this, okay? If you want them to look like they're overlapping, see, I was going for a more bumpy look, but here's the other way to do it. And I'm doing it quick. Don't, you know, take more time. All right, so you see that first layer there? And you have to do every one. You have to do every one if you want the effect. Okay, now I'm going to take the lighter. Well, let me go ahead and take the white first. I'm going to go down here at the bottom. The bottom of every one, I'm going to lighten up. Okay, each one. Okay, I'm only doing this little section here, right? All right, now I'm going to take the medium green and kind of blend. Need a little bit more. I need to take my green down just a little with light pressure so that I can have something to blend with. You can do this kind of scale. Now, see, what you're gonna have, what you're not gonna see is how I have to go back and fix this to look like those. But I wanted to show you guys. So I'm going over the white. And see, they kind of look like they're overlapping now. You can do, so this just shows you that depending on where you throw your shade, that will be the effect you get. Okay, so they're the exact same shapes, but look at the difference. The difference in, see? So just with the same colors, but just where you put your shading, there's your difference. From this to this, exact same shapes. They're this shape, exact same shape. But if you shade this way or you shade this way, this is what you get. See? So, all right, guys. So we're heading out. Hope y'all enjoyed it. We got lots more to do. I'll try to save it. Ugh. I save so many pages for the next time. You know, and sometimes it's a couple weeks before we get back to it. So, yeah. All right, guys. But I hope you got some ideas anyway. Even if we never finish this, hopefully you get some ideas. Because that's what I like to do. That's for me, sharing ideas, different techniques, things like this. That's fun for me to show you different things like this. Right? All right, guys. So thanks for being here. Thanks, Terry. Thanks, everybody. I don't know if Janet wants to put a link in. Because when I leave, guys, I shut off links. And if I forget to shut off links and my mods remember to shut off links, please do. Because I don't want to leave my channel unattended when we're all gone. And people can still come in and put links. You know? So, yeah. Thanks, Jean. So, yeah, if anybody wants to put in links, Jean, if you want to put in your link. Thanks, Fran. Janet can put in her link, or anybody else wants to put in their link before we head out. And, yeah, so thanks for being here, guys.